I became an artist as a little kid when I realized that drawing was a way to pass through a very difficult illness that almost took my life. I spent days and hours just drawing and drawing. So in many ways, the studio practice is embedded in the way I work. The idea to keep working, even if I'm not very pleased with the results on what I'm doing, that if you keep going and going, suddenly you find or stumble upon a good result, is an idea I live with. I guess that's the difference between fabrication and creation. At the end, maybe I'm just very stubborn. Going back to the studio was a very weird moment. A mix of feelings. I was finally back, but the place was like entering a home you fled and hasn't been opened ever since. The studio keeps its stories through the objects it shelters, and it felt there were many stories untold or unfinished, like broken pieces that now need to be joined. So it's really not easy to know where to start. I'm very interested in the notion of art being an act of freedom. The multiplicity of places to work in my studio, very different one from another, helps me to focus on diverse practices where I can develop different concerns and different ideas, to try different things, like a writer moving between essay, fiction, and poetry. I like the cross-pollination between different media, between different spaces, and between conceptual thinking and material working, because at the end, everything combines, even if it's not visible in the final work, in the final result. I think my work is often associated to concrete blocks and tie-downs. But if you look carefully, you would also find a strong presence of rocks, marble in its raw state, and glass sheets. It is about the dialogue between industrialized materials and primitive ones. You are able to find metal beams of same proportions and width, glass to the same thickness, wood cut in the same shape in China, Brazil, or France. I mean, this is a human convention. It's a way to democratize materials and to make people who use these materials for construction purposes communicate more easily, while marble or stone, for example, are always unique. There are never two equal, just like a fingerprint or like a seashell. That diversity and uniqueness is utterly poetic. At the end of it all, I'm a big art admirer. Artists that trigger your mind and your emotions is something that I find really appealing. It's fascinating. The ones who create their own universe and expand artistic language. Artists who, because of them, art never ceases to evolve. I've been inspired by many artists over the years. It would practically be impossible to name them all. The library in my studio plays a very important role. It's a continuous source of research and inspiration. That's why some of my work also addresses art history and quotes other works of art that I find pivotal in the development of critical thinking. So basically, I'm just really glad to be back in my studio again.